guess I'm a bit of a ninja because I like to climb high things, high buildings, high structures, just because it's fun and because to get art up in some really ridiculous places where A, it can't be taken down and B, everyone can see it there and why not?
I never used to draw faces at all. I had a show, I was pushing myself to learn how to draw faces. And I think once I was practicing them and I sort of nailed it and I got the light bulb moment where I thought, oh, I know where the shade is now and I can work it out. Really trying to find out what it is that makes them beautiful even though they're all different.
I'm very nimble, I can climb things, but I'm not really an aggressive person, hence the paint brushes for swords in my costume. I guess I'm an art warrior of sorts. Yeah, I like to thank Dr. Seuss. I grew up with him. I think that's a really good, strong mirror to my work. It's very whimsical and playful and doesn't mean anything. It's just art. It's just great.
We both have our own aspects of the artwork.
We work together the whole way through. I don't just hand it over and walk away either. When you're collabing, you're not just drawing side by side, but you're actually working together for a whole piece.
We have free reign to screw around with each other's work. We've got a lot of trust. Even if they're wiping out a big section of what you painted, it's not a... we're not going to be ruining it. A lot of my artwork still looks very childlike. Now I illustrate and do some design work. All of my artwork has the same set of eyes. I suppose it's the one identifying feature of my artwork. You can look at it and know that it's mine straight away.
No, I love West End. I've been in and out of the area for years. Yeah, I'm surprised there's not more art here. I guess you could say it's fresh ground. It's kind of why I started, actually. I looked around and I thought Brisbane needed more culture and more of that. I'm different to most other artists. My street art images are very planned and methodical. I use cut-out wood, very simple shapes. I don't use spray paint. I do work right in the middle of the city, everywhere that you shouldn't do art, and stood out a bit. Well, actually, my goal was for street art to be recognised by like by all, not just seen as graffiti. Like, I don't really consider it as graffiti. I do very nice animals and shapes and plants and things like that. Yeah, I like to think that people are on their way to work and they see it and they like it, and that you wouldn't want to remove it unless perhaps it was your job. Street artists are trying to be amazing and trying to be beautiful, not just... it's art for art's sake, really.
Mine's realistic and Ben sort of has this fantasy world that he lives in, and they just work really well, don't they?
Yeah, when we did our first one I didn't actually think it was going to work because we were so different, but we found our middle ground. Now that each one is totally different, each one works really well.
It's often taken in a bad light, graffiti, like it's not meant to be there, but it's so much different than your controlled gallery art. Yeah, so we're motivated by nothing else other than to do art. So whatever energy I put into it just shone back. That's a reflection of that, you know, the sort of bringing peace into the urban environment.